Hello, Lakers Nation. Sean Davis here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. And it's time. Denver Lakers. I put out a tweet at Sean_DAVI wondering what your biggest questions were heading into this Lakers and Nuggets matchup. And easily, the two top requested things. So number one, how do you guard Jamal Murray, Nikola Jokic pick and rolls? And two, how do we guard Nikola Jokic post-up attempts? Well, today in this video, guys, I'm going to attempt to give you guys my take on how the Lakers should guard these two popular offensive engines from the Denver Nuggets. This is based off of extensive film analysis that I did and based using some experience from my coaching background and things like that, and how I would prepare for the Denver Nuggets and specifically trying to limit those two factors. So I hope you guys enjoy this film breakdown. If you guys are new, please leave a like as well and subscribe here to the channel. We have a bunch of more great content covering this Lakers playoffs team, and then obviously into the offseason as well. If you want more great film content, follow me on Twitter at Sean_DAVI. With that being said, let's get to this film breakdown and let's break down how the Lakers can try to neutralize some of the Nuggets' favorite offensive actions.
So the first thing that we're going to be addressing in this video is going to be the topic of how do you guard Nikola Jokic post-ups. I am a fan of doubling Jokic in the post, but this possession here is specifically one I'm not a fan of. So you have the ball entering Jokic, and it's a double from the strong side. That is a bad idea. Reason being, because you just let Jokic get the easiest pass available to him. Whereas the goal as a defense should be to limit the quality of shot, and you live with the result. And this possession, yeah, Denver misses, but it's bad process because over a 7-game series, this is a shot that KCP is more likely gonna hit more times than not. So this is a possession that I really like. The Warriors are going to double from the weak side here. So the strong side defender stays with Jamal Murray. That leaves a 3-on-2 on the backside. You're going to get a slot cut, and you're going to get a baseline cut from Christian Brown. And the activity here is super, super important. You see Reggie Jackson wide open, but the active hands forces Jokic to make this pass down low. Great hands by Brandon Pajemski. And Jokic is playmaking, does get weakened if you're able to send these weak side doubles. The efficiency of the Nuggets offense severely drops when they go to actions like this, or teams double like this. This is the type of doubles that I want to send at Jokic. So this is one of my favorite possessions here. I love it a lot. Again, we're going back to this weak side double with the Warriors. They're gonna do a bump, so we're gonna call this a weak side double plus a bump. Steph Curry bumps down on Aaron Gordon to take away the dump off, and essentially the Warriors are going to zone up here. So Chris Paul stays one pass away, and what the Warriors do such a good job of right there is they execute what's called a peel switch. As soon as the ball is released, Steph just peels off, and Kevon Looney dives down executing a switch and getting the matchup back where it wants it to be if the ball does get there, and the Warriors ultimately get a steal here. Great execution. This, again, type of stuff I want to see from the Lakers. Now, just because I want the Lakers to double, there is, again, definitely ways you have to do it. Watch here. This is arguably a rookie mistake by Derek Lively. There is nobody bumping down for the Dallas Mavericks. So here, Derek Lively just has to stay home because Aaron Gordon is already calling for this ball. This is where Jokic does get those easy dump-offs and those easy assists. Aaron Gordon, this is his superpower in the Denver Nuggets offense. Either you have to bump down from that weak side corner, which does leave that corner three ball open right there, or you just have to play this one-on-one. A rookie mistake, honestly, just a bad schematic choice by Dallas, and it gets them burned. The Lakers have even done some of the stuff that we've talked about. They send a weak side double team, or just help, rather. They send theirs late, but when they do send it, Jokic goes to AD one-on-one. Jokic drives the baseline. The Lakers zone up. They send him up as Christian Wood coming over late at the rim. And it just forces Jokic to make a pass a lot more quicker and make the decision a lot quicker than he wants to. And it forces the turnover. And this is the type of stuff that I want to see from this Lakers team. And they've shown the upside to do it, like this clip here. So to review, the three things I want the Lakers to do with Jokic are, one, weak side double plus a bump. This is the most effective coverage that I've found. It also makes sure you take away any opportunity for a guy like Aaron Gordon down low. Number two, let them play one-on-one with Anthony Davis. AD and the Lakers have one of the best performances of any team that went one-on-one with Jokic. I would go to that a little bit. And number three, just weak side help in general. Not even necessarily doubles, but just trying to deter some of the passes from this Nuggets offense. The biggest key with this Nuggets team is you have to try to throw off some of the timing for their post-up actions. And that is why I'm sending some weak side doubles and making Jokic see bodies. Now it's time to break down Jamal Murray's pick and roll game, which is obviously a hassle to guard. Now, I know I said I would like to see the Lakers run drop coverage or switch, but I'm going to change my mind here, and here's why. The Nuggets go to their 21 series here. And this is a bad possession from the Heat. It starts off bad. The Heat should just switch that guard-to-guard screen. But I think there's really good film of teams hedging or putting two on the ball in Jamal Murray pick and rolls. Now, problem number one is for the Heat, the low man does a bad job of really coming over and tagging. He needs to be there on the, I mean, just now, essentially. And now it's way too easy of a pass for Jamal Murray to get it into the post. But what you cannot do here is you cannot allow Aaron Gordon to seal you off like this. There needs to be room between you and the rim and Aaron Gordon. You have to be splitting the rim and Aaron Gordon. It's too easy. But if the Heat execute this right, the only pass that is going to be available now is going to be an Aaron Gordon cross-court skip pass with help there. And you just have to rotate. So just trust your rotations here. And this would have been a good possession. A good possession here by the Heat. Now, if I were to nitpick, I would prefer Duncan Robinson kind of inch back closer to his man because this does become a pretty easy pass for Jamal Murray. But you ultimately do your job. You get the ball out of Jamal Murray's hands and you force a kick out to a guy you're willing to let shoot. Just a bad breakdown in coverage here by the Dallas Mavericks. And this is why I say you have to be ready to rotate on the back end. The low man in this possession for the Mavericks does not do a good job of fully tagging on the roll. He's kind of playing halfway here still. So when the ball gets to the roller, he is just able to immediately elevate up and explode without having to face any contact at the rim. This is too easy for the Nuggets offense, where if the low man is already there on the pass, you force a kick out and you have another player, PJ Washington, ready to rotate, and we're good. You can't have these lapses if you're facing Denver and you want to put two on the ball with Jamal Murray. Fun possession to break down here. So the Nuggets go to a high pick and roll with Jokic and Murray, and the Kings are aggressively putting two on the ball. They've already tagged on the Jokic roll, and that makes Keegan Murray as the low man here. Keegan Murray's responsibility is to play the Aaron Gordon potential baseline cut and still be able to recover out to Justin Holiday, who's actually shaking up. So this is a really, really good set to beat this type of coverage. And Keegan Murray does his job. The shakeup does change up his responsibilities just a little bit. It makes his job harder, but he does his job to perfection here, and you live with this shot from Justin Holiday instead of giving up a Jamal Murray easy pull-up or a dump-off pass to Aaron Gordon for a dunk. Is it easy to guard Jamal Murray, Nikola Jokic in this high-powered Denver Nuggets offense? No, it isn't. If it was, then everybody would be able to do it. But I think there are legitimate ways that the Lakers are watching the same film that they can really exploit and try to make life as difficult as possible for Jokic and Murray, which has me feeling really, really confident heading into this series.
Thank you guys so much for tuning into this breakdown, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you all are new, please make sure you guys smash that like button and subscribe here for more content. I really hope you guys are able to take something away from this breakdown. It's a ton of fun making. And once again, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please give me a follow on Twitter at @Shaw_DAVI for more X's and O's breakdowns and other great content. Till next time, everybody. See ya. Stay safe. Peace out.